Hello, welcome to the Wednesday, May 23rd, 2018 edition of the Sand Unit Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Reston, Virginia. Xavier came across an interesting trick being used to get Excel files to execute code. Now, this can always be done with macros, but of course, these macros have to be approved by the user. The other trick that Xavier came across this week is silk files. Now, silk files, the extension is .slk, are essentially files used to exchange data between applications, and Excel can read these files. Actually, they're usually represented using sort of an Excel-like icon on the screen. When you open a file like this, then it will ask you if it can update data for a spreadsheet, which will then trigger the code. In the example found by Xavier, the code being executed is a short PowerShell script that will download malware and then execute it. So double check that you are blocking these files on your mail servers, because one way how your users would be exposed to these files is by receiving them as an email attachment. Because the file type is a little bit unusual, you may not be looking for it at this point, and anti-malware may not consider it as malicious. And BMW released a firmware update for some of its higher-end cars to address vulnerabilities found by Keen Security Lab. Keen Security Lab did release a report with a lot of details about these attacks. Some of these attacks can actually be executed remotely, either via Bluetooth or via the cellular network. So for the cellular attack, the car would have to connect to a malicious base station. The vulnerabilities affect BMWs with an internet-connected infotainment system, also known as head unit, and telematics control unit. Now, one particular concern is that this will then reach all the way to the ODB bus, so an attacker who gains access to these systems via, for example, these wireless remote means would have full control over the car. Also, some of the diagnostic messages that are only supposed to really work if the car is at rest are also working when the car is driving at normal speed. So there are real safety implications in these attacks, which is why you probably should check and make sure that your car is not on the list of cars to be patched. Now, while the report is quite detailed in what they were able to accomplish, there are no proof of concepts yet, and probably not enough detail for someone to actually create an exploit. Keen Lab will wait until 2019, so until next year, to publish additional details in order to give people a chance to update their cars. And anti-malware company Malwarebytes has uncovered a Mac version of the famous XMRig cryptocoiner malware. Now, this malware is often seen on Unix systems, so porting it to the Mac probably didn't take that much work, and no surprise that we see it on Macs. Now, at this point, Malwarebytes doesn't know yet how this particular piece of malware ended up on these particular systems. So the actual dropper or the mechanism that was used to infect the Mac is still unknown. But from past experience, typically users installed it themselves, believing that it was some kind of other beneficial malware, like maybe a flash player or some other form of video player. That's probably the most common way how we have seen this kind of malware being installed. Malwarebytes points out that there are a couple of other crypto coin miners that have been seen on the Mac, and of course good old JavaScript cryptojacking should work on the Mac just like on any other system that is able to process JavaScript in the browser. And just like other operating system vendors, VMware has released an update to address the most recent version of the Spectre flaws that I talked about yesterday. This affects VMware vSphere, Workstation, and Fusion. So essentially, also the desktop virtualization products are affected by this flaw. And well, that's it for today. So thanks for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.